some noise for Nutlai Lalbiakkima!
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. You've been watching DJMC Boxing Presents Countdown to the Middle East Crown Series 4. And my name is Arjun Chibalkati. My co-commentator, Nick, world champion in his own right. And now, Nick, it gets interesting because we are down to a 10-round world title fight for the WBC Asia Continental Light Flyweight title.
The moment we've been waiting for.
The moment we've all been waiting for. We've had a great fight night. We've had some amazing knockouts, some TKOs, a little bit of controversy, and now it gets down to all the marbles, all seriousness. Nutlai Lalbiakkima.
We have two main interesting fighters tonight.
Today, Nutlai is a India number one. He is 4-0 with 4 KOs. That says something. He's an IBA international champion. He's an IBA intercontinental champion. And he's coming to take on a world-ranked 47, Jayson Vayson from Philippines. I honestly cannot wait for this one because we've been talking about this fight all day.
I spoke to Jason the other day, and Jason was very confident that he's coming to teach him a lesson.
Wow, he says that?
And he was saying that his opponent fighting. He has seen all his previous fight, and he was saying that all he has done was to study his fight.
You know what the funny thing is? Both these guys, I asked them a question saying, who do you emulate, who do you respect, who do you like? And they both said Manny Pacquiao.
That's right.
They both said Manny Pacquiao. It's going to get interesting because Manny Pacquiao is an offensive style fighter.
And both their offensive style.
Exactly.
And so both their very, very offensive style.
When two offensive style fighters fight, somebody's going to sleep.
And it's the beginning of the fire.
I love the fire. So we're waiting
for it. Let's see. Jason have a very good career. He has 9 fights on his record.
Yes, he's 9-0. He's got only one loss, and he's had 5 KOs. But now we introduce him.
Making his way to the ring, Nutlai Lalbiakkima.
After Jayson Vayson, we introduce Nutlai Lalbiakkima from India, 5 foot tall, just 26 years of age, but comes in with 4 KOs. I made a mistake in the previous introduction. I think I introduced Nutlai instead of Jayson Vayson. So let's switch it around again. Nutlai comes in with a lot of experience. He's young, he's hungry, and
both fighters are very young.
Both fighters are young. Both fighters are hungry.
Very hungry.
The experience slightly goes to Jayson Vayson. He's got more pro fights. Yeah. He's had 9 wins. He's got 5 KOs. So both these guys have the ability to stop the fight. They're both technical. And ladies and gentlemen, if you thought these boxers this far were fast, you haven't seen speed yet. Super flyweights are fast.
They have crazy fucking speed.
They have crazy, crazy speed. And you guys just don't blink. It's going to happen in a blink of an eye.
And don't forget, we have a title fight scheduled now. They're fighting for the WBC Asian title.
Yep, in the fight for the WBC Continental title.
Yep.
So you can see all the members.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we begin, we request everybody in the arena to please stand for the national anthem of United Arab Emirates. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the national anthem of UAE.
وعاش العلم يا إماراتنا رمز العروبة كل لك فيك بدنا نرويك تبنيك بالأرواح يا وطن.
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the national anthem of the Philippines and India. Please remain standing for the national anthem of the Philippines and India. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get on with the program. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment all the fans around here have been waiting for. Dubai, are you ready? Live from the World Trade Center in Dubai, this is the main event of the evening. This fight is a title fight for the WBC Asia Continental title. Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is supervised by the WBC supervisor from Lithuania, Oksana Semeshina. All right, ladies and gentlemen, first we introduce the red corner. His professional record, 9 wins, 1 draw, 5 by way of knockout. The world rank 47, representing the Philippines, make some noise for Jayson Vayson! And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner, his professional record, 4 wins, all by way of knockout, the IBA International Champion and the IBA Intercontinental Champion, representing India, make some noise for Nutlai Lalbiakkima! Ladies and gentlemen, as the action begins, the referee for the fight, Maksat Asnam.
People want to see boxing. Please listen to me. No low blow, no pushing, no racing, no head up.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's just gotten very, very serious in here. It's a title fight. WBC Asia Continental light flyweight title between Jayson Vayson and Nutlai Lalbiakkima. It's India versus Philippines. Both fighters are experienced, and you can see the crowd has come alive. A lot of people are suddenly have approached the stage. A lot of guys are coming together. Nick, 10 rounds of fury. Who will take it home? Only time will tell as DJMC promotions, DJMC boxing's countdown to the Middle East crown comes to an end after this title fight. Nice low jabs by both men. Oh, beautiful combination by Jayson Vayson. You can see that they've both started off. You know, there's no waiting for these guys. There's no warm-up period.
Like I said, from the word go, yeah. These boxers are fast.
Oh my! It's really difficult. We have to look at the screen all the time to see what's happening there.
And they are both boxers are very promising. So this fight, they take it with heart.
No, it's going to be an interesting, incredible fight because it's going to come down to, you know, both these guys have the ability to land knockouts. Both these guys have knockout power.
I've seen Nutlai fighting.
Yep.
I've seen how he finish up.
Nutlai fighting as well.
I've seen how he finish up his opponent.
Beautiful.
I've seen his power.
Wow. I mean, it's ridiculous how close these guys are come to actually, you know, ending the fight with one shot.
And you can tell from the first round, yeah? You cannot judge the first round with how the performance.
You could just see Nutlai landed a great body shot and Jayson Vayson winced a little bit. He didn't like that one bit. You can see his right hand a little low, trying to protect that body.
I think this is his style.
No, it's a little bit of his style, sure, because he's throwing out that jab and then he's turning.
Oh,
beautiful right hook that landed Nutlai. Nutlai ate it like a champion.
What Jason need to do, he need to keep this on a little bit because Nutlai can fight.
Nutlai can
fight. He can fight and he can box.
And he can take a punch.
And he can take a punch.
And he can keep up. Both these men can keep up the pace. But you can see he's going for the body. Nutlai's got a good strategy.
He's digging deep for the body shot.
Both these guys landing good body shots.
Referee giving instructions to keep it clean, both boxes.
Yeah, that's the worrisome part. Good body shot again, both these men. And you can see the dirty boxing in the clinch. Both these men.
Good job from Nutlai.
Beautiful jab by Nutlai. A little bit of the shovel punch.
Nutlai is doing a very good job.
Nutlai very aggressive, coming in very aggressively.
Regardless of the distance and the range that Jayson is keeping.
Exactly. Jayson is staying patient. He's keeping his range. But, you know, it's. I know both these men know it's a title fight. Big right hook.
Big right from...
Big left hook. Nutlai getting off balance with those shots. Man, he's putting everything into those shots. But, you know, that we talked about the fact that this is a 10-round fight. It's a title fight. And we're end of round number one. It's a title fight. But I don't see these boys facing themselves out there. They've got the pedal to the metal.
According to the first round, yeah, I think Nutlai need to keep. He need to stop rushing too much into this fight because Jayson have realized
he's getting off balance.
Yes, he's getting off balance. No,
yeah.
Now the second round, he will try to keep it calm and wait for him.
Beautiful combination by Jayson Vayson. Caught him with an uppercut, and Nutlai came over with a nice left right himself. But Jayson has landed the more cleaner shots. Nutlai
right.
is a little wilder. He's coming in with fury. He's coming in trying to take his head off. But Jayson is staying patient. That's where the experience advantage comes in.
Now I'm saying, Jayson, I think this time round, Nutlai need to understand that he need to stop rushing because
exactly.
Jayson is a boxer. And he's kind of be waiting to do some counter punches. And
Jayson,
which really
yeah.
worked for him in the yeah. first round.
And Jayson is staying calm. He's staying patient. He's letting Nutlai come to him. He's looking to land. He landed a beautiful uppercut and hook counter in the previous round. Good head movement.
Good job from Jayson.
Jayson, the taller of the two fighters, a little longer arms and legs. He's got
he's
a
keeping
slight
distance.
Reach advantage. Good jabs by Jayson. Good job also from Nutlai. He's keeping
it. That's the thing about Nutlai. He's just jumping over with that ferocious right hand, trying to hit something, and he's telegraphing that shot.
But he need, yeah, that what I was telling you. But he has good power, man.
He's got great power.
He's crazy power.
But man, the power is no good if you can't land it. But that body, big right hook. But that body shot, man, it's like a fastball. He's looking for a fastball with that right hand.
I saw him knocking out his opponent last event when I...
Oh my God, that was brutal. Nutlai, good combinations by Jayson.
Good combination from Jayson, yeah.
Great hand speed shown by Jayson Vayson, and you can see he's trying to stay patient. It's Nutlai. He can't allow Nutlai to stop that
habit he has of jumping inside.
Exactly.
Because he can get caught out.
But the thing is that Nutlai is quite effective in the short range. The minute he gets him up against the ropes, Nutlai lands some good body shots, and that left hook is a whisker away from hitting Jayson. Jayson trying to counter Nutlai as he steps in. But man, what a frenetic pace of this fight. I think they've thrown more punches in the first two rounds than all the other fights combined.
Good job from Nutlai.
I wish we had a fight metric stand on the fight.
Oh my God. Nutlai doing good, very job.
It's that overhand right that he's looking for, but he's not landing very clean. He's setting it up. Beautiful jab by Jayson. He snapped his head back.
Jayson need to remember that the way he's doing his counter punches is catching him.
Exactly.
So he need to keep on doing the same thing he's doing.
Exactly.
But he cannot allow Nutlai to keep on jumping on him.
No, and you can see that Jason's made the adjustments. The minute Nutlai steps in, he's looking for that uppercut if he dips low. And see again, he turns away from that. But now this is where it gets dangerous, because now he's got him tied up against the ropes. And that's why Nutlai is trying to use a little bit, you know, beautiful jab by Nutlai.
Nutlai is really doing a good job, despite of his, despite that Jayson is trying to keep the distance.
No, Jayson has got a great strategy. He's constantly moving. But you know, I realize this in boxing, moving backwards is so tiring, because you're constantly on your back foot. Oh, beautiful left hook. You can see that caught Jason's attention. And Jayson coming back with a combination of his own. Both these men are in it to win it. Neither of them are
Everybody
holding back.
Knows. Yeah.
And that's the end of round number two. Big swing and a miss at the end of it. We get ready for number three.
What do you think?
It's hard, man. I think Nutlai has a slight edge so far. Mm-hmm. I would give a slight edge, but it's Jason's counters are cleaner.
That's right.
We take a look at the replay there. You can just see here. Nutlai's body shots are landing over and over. But that uppercut from Jayson is clean, is precise. A lot of these shots are deflected and have been hitting the arms and the body. Good defense by Jayson, but is that one punch that gets through? That's the one that got through, that left hook.
So most of Nutlai punches are not connecting.
No, it's not clean. But it's you know, it's that
they're landing,
aggression.
But they're not clean.
Yeah, they're landing on the arms. But you know what? Don't think for a second that doesn't take it out of you. After a couple of rounds, that your arms start getting heavy. I mean, if I get into a ring right now, my arms will be heavy in 10 seconds. I won't have to fight more than 10 seconds because I will knock it. I'm kidding.
We go to that
jokes
round.
Jokes apart, third round has begun for this amazing title fight for the WBC Asia Continental Light Flyweight title. Nice left hook counter by Jayson Vayson. And Nutlai looking to attack the body. Now this is where it's dangerous for Jayson. When he lets himself stand.
But I don't know why he keep on dropping past his front.
Again,
his
another left hook. That left hook, the minute he turns to his right, that's why he's turning away. He's turning to his left.
He's showing
away from that left hand of Nutlai.
He's showing Nutlai that he's allowing him to punch him.
Very nice combination. No, it's the fear of that right hand. But he's still turning towards the right, so he needs to be careful, because Nutlai can if he times him with one of those fastballs that he calls a right.
And you've seen Nutlai with good body shot and right overhand.
Exactly, and the body shots are coming constantly, and the jab as well. Nutlai is landing a lot more cleaner in this round. He's got his guard up. You can see his corner just giving instructions. Urvashi, she won a championship belt in series two. And I've said this, Nick, we've discussed this time and time again. Those body shots can snap you of your energy. They can take your cardio away.
You can see from this round, Jayson has at least he's been gassed out.
He's slowing down a little bit, but it's because of those body shots.
That's right.
And Nutlai is managing to keep up the pace. Nice work there. Good combination by both the men, and good snapping jab by Nutlai.
Trading too much punches.
I'm telling you, the amount of punches landed in this fight has surpassed all the fights put together.
That's right.
Beautiful counter by Jayson. Nice left hook. Trying to come up with that overhand right again. But that's the thing. Now, Nutlai is getting a little predictable with that overhand right because Jayson is seeing it coming a mile away. And he's dipping low, Jayson is trying to time him with that uppercut.
But Nutlai has been aggressive.
He is.
And he's landing clean punches.
He's finding more success with that left hook.
Jayson needs to keep the distance because he have realized that Nutlai, each and every time he's coming close to him, he's trying to land some body shot and some right overhand.
Exactly. And he is landing those body shots. If he can't get the head, he looks for the body. There you go again. This is the fifth time that we've seen that left hook land. Oh, beautiful overhand right.
Same thing I keep on telling.
And you can see from the face of Jayson is that damage is wearing on him a little bit now.
And he needs to keep the distance. If he needs to survive, he needs to keep the distance.
Because if
he allow himself to get punished this way,
exactly.
I don't see this fight going to the end.
No, maybe not. Maybe we might see a stoppage earlier because Nutlai has now got him backed up in that corner. And the referee is certainly getting a workout in this fight. It's a short ring.
Jayson really needs to work. He cannot allow Nutlai to keep on punching him this way.
Yeah, because he's landing a couple of counters from time to time, but they're not landing clean. After this last round, I think Nutlai has turned it around a little bit because he's landed the better combinations. You can see that straight, beautiful left hand and that right hand that landed over and over. But Jayson had some good moments of his own. He landed some good counters, but again and again, he landed that left, look at that combination, body and head. He landed that over and over, and that right hand will soon get in this last round. Three times he found success with that left.
What I'm saying, whatever that Nutlai is doing, is connecting
it's
and
working,
working for
it's
him.
Working.
And it's working for him. What Jayson is not doing, he need to keep his distance away, and he need to use his jab, which is dropping his hand down.
Yeah, and he's trying to time him coming in, and that is what is allowing him to close the distance. Because I think Nutlai is okay with eating one or two in the pocket just so that he can land a shot of his own. See, there you go again. He closes that distance. Jayson does a great job of circling out.
Nutlai is a fighter. He's a boxer. He's ready for whatever that Jayson bring.
Both these men have come here to fight. Oh, beautiful left. That left has found a home over and over. The minute he switches to southpaw, that left has had success. You can see in orthodox, when he throws that right hand, Jason's ready for it. But in southpaw, he doesn't see that left hand coming. Good body work by Jayson. Jayson trying to take the center
Jayson
of the ring.
Jayson needs to keep his left hand up, and he needs to use his jab more to chase him away, to keep him distance, to keep him away.
Again with that left. See, the minute he switches, right now he's fighting southpaw. And Nutlai is finding great success. Good counters by Jayson.
If Jayson counter punches, if he go on counter punches, it's working. But if he stays sluggish, Nutlai is working.
Lot of instructions being screamed out by both the corners.
Jayson need to do one more thing.
Is it just me, or I think from Jason's right eye is bleeding?
It's red. Yeah,
it's really red. I think
he got caught with a straight right.
Because it's that left which is constantly connecting the eye over and over again. Again with that left hook.
Same.
I'm telling you, Nutlai is fighting better in southpaw.
So then he need to stay on the southpaw and work.
But this,
if you're tall in the ring, you need to use your reach.
Yes.
Which Jayson is not doing.
Again, beautiful right hand, and Jayson now looking to come after him. But right now, Nutlai is again with that left hand.
Nutlai is hungry, and he wants it all.
If he keeps fighting like this, he looks like he's going to be able to reach his goal tonight.
He's really doing good.
It's a little bit of a wardrobe malfunction. The WBC sticker on the shorts looks like it's hanging out. And I think the referee has not noticed it yet. Nutlai putting on a clinic, putting on the pace. But like you said, Nick, he's now slowed down a little bit. He's realized it's a title fight. We're in the fourth round. I can't put him away that quickly.
He's
so
not
I'm gonna
going
to lean
down.
On him. I'm gonna going to hurt him.
Down.
And see the body work, the constant body. The minute they get into the shorter range, beautiful counter from Jayson, but good body shots
from
Nutlai. By Nutlai.
Good job from both boxers. Trading some heavy punches.
Oh, heavy punches.
Oh, my God.
Beautiful combination with Jayson at the end of that round. What a fight, ladies and gentlemen. We have a fight on our hands.
We go to fifth round now.
Wow. I mean, it's now going to be the halfway mark. Five rounds and then five more after that. But we've got, it's incredible. Jayson, at the start of that round, looked a little weary. He was getting caught by Nutlai. We can see that left. The minute Nutlai fought southpaw, the approach changed. And that's what created the openings. Jayson can see that right hand coming.
You can see all the power punches that connected were from the straight over right hand.
Yeah.
And whenever that Nutlai used them, it's catching. It's working for him.
The thing is that he's catching him with that left hand. It's not the overhand right. The overhand right is missing.
And whenever he switched to southpaw, it's working for him.
It is. It really is. He's doing a fantastic job. And again, now he's back in orthodox. He's back in orthodox. He's going to look to establish that jab. And Jayson is on his bike. You can see the length. Now he's using his length a little more. He's extending those hands and trying to block him from coming in. Beautiful
good
body shot. Nice uppercut by Jayson. Are we seeing a change in tide here in the fifth round? Maybe we're changing. We're looking at a different. We're looking at a different Jayson. He's a little more aggressive. Nice combinations. Beautiful combinations by Jayson. And Lalbiakkima comes over the top. I think he needs to switch to southpaw.
I think southpaw was working better for
him. Southpaw was working way better for him. But I think, you know, he's received the corner instructions.
I think now they realize that the distance was not working for him. Good body shot, good counter.
Now, but Jayson has been landing the counters in this fight. See, again, beautiful shovel punch. Caught his opponent coming in. But Lalbiakkima is a gamer. Oh, and then he stepped in with that left hook. Good body shot there. But you can see both these boys are having a good time. It's all sportsmanship.
Having fun.
They're
this
smiling.
Is what I call boxing.
Yeah, this is what I call boxing.
Yeah, both fighters, they know we're doing this for fun. We're doing this for a championship, and you cannot come and take it away from me.
No.
Both of them, they need it. Both of them want it.
But that's the beauty of DJMC boxing. It's a promotion that gives an opportunity for young fighters for a chance at the belt. And it's incredible because the fighters realize it, that under the promotion they have a great chance to make a mark, to put on a show for the fans. Because sometimes you've seen boxers that just try to coast, you know, try to win on a few points. But these guys are going for it. They're gunning for gold.
This time, I think Jayson woke up from his sleeping bed.
Yeah, Jason's awake. And he's landing much better counters.
Yeah, than before.
It's a much, much better round for Jayson.
But I like the smile from Nutlai.
Yeah, he smiles every time he gets tagged.
Every time, yeah.
He smiles every time he gets tagged.
Good double jab from Jayson.
Man, I got to say one thing. It's just the conditioning of both these men is insane. To take this kind of damage and just keep this pace after all that damage is just something special.
Sometimes, you know, when I'm looking boxing, yeah, I think I'm not a boxer. When I'm watching boxing.
Why?
The kind of punching I see people trading in.
Oh, man. No, come on. Do not sell yourself short, my friend.
Good job from both boxers.
Good head movement. He's got beautiful jab. And Jayson stepped into that one. And this is the first time we're seeing Jayson now becoming the aggressor. Got caught with that left hook again by Nutlai. But this round number five has been all Jayson.
You're talking about them. They have... all of them, they have the similarity of Manny Pacquiao fighting style.
Exactly.
Where Manny Pacquiao was fighting in this on this weight.
You can see his corner. You can see Urvashi Singh giving him instructions. She's a champion too. She's been in this position and she won in the eighth round by a body shot. Sorry, in the fifth round by a body shot.
So he need, he has a good, his team is well equipped with a
He's a great team. He's got a great team and she's a great boxer. She's telling him, and the first thing she's like, calm down, slow down. You got time, you got five more rounds.
Yeah, you have to keep it clean. Don't let your energy get wasted in the first round, the second round, the third round.
Exactly.
We saw Jason. We saw Jason that round doing a couple of good rounds, doing good job.
And you can see he's being instructed by Liana and Urvashi Singh. So he's got some great advice in his corner. Here we go. This is round number six now that we get started with. We are now literally at the halfway mark.
That's right.
We've gotten five rounds in, and this is a tough one to score. I mean. Jayson Vayson has started to pull this back. In the last round, he showed some stellar counter-punching. He caught Nutlai coming in on multiple occasions. And Nutlai looked a little slower in that fifth round. See, he's got his hands up, he's got his guard up, and now he's looking to counter.
Good combination for both boxers.
Both boxers landing, and Jayson doing a good job of getting out of harm's way.
You have to keep your heads up. Oh my God.
Very nice left hand. Sorry, right hand by Nutlai.
See, I like the point that you say when Nutlai is switching to southpaw, it's working for him rather than staying on orthodox, because each and every time he stays on orthodox.
Yeah, because now he's open. He's now getting countered and beat up by Jayson, who just landed a beautiful overhand right. You can see the swelling under the left eye of Nutlai. It's come from those right hands that Jason's been landing since the last round. And I think he's a little fatigued as well. You can see he's starting to slow down. But he needs to switch to southpaw because he got a lot more success.
We have to fix the tape.
He's going to take a look at the tape afterwards, and he's going to realize that perhaps that he had better access from that southpaw stance, because that left hand was landing so often. It was landing over and over again, and it was incredible. I loved it. I loved the approach that he had for the entire thing. It was incredible.
Good job from Nutlai.
Nice stinging jab. But you can see Jayson has got a hold of his timing now. And he's timing him coming in. Every time he's stepping in, he's making him pay for it. Every time he's stepping in, he's making Nutlai pay for it. Another shot left catching him. And he's doing such a good job of rolling out of trouble.
Good job from Nutlai.
Yes. Good job from Jayson.
Good job from Nutlai also. He responded with the same punch.
But it's Jayson that's landing the better counters. He's catching Nutlai coming in every time. Again, both fighters landing jabs.
Beautiful. Good job from Jayson, doing good job.
Jayson since the last round has turned this fight around completely and has taken control over this. He started countering and timing him perfectly. And, you know, maybe Nutlai is just taking it slow for these two rounds because he knows it's going to go longer. And he's got four more rounds after this.
I think he realized from the second round that he's not going to bring down Jayson.
No, he's not. I think he...
So the game plan changed automatically.
Yes, the game plan changed. They're going to be looking. But this is what is... Now, this is the problem. When if you try to stand with the technical striker will pick you apart. And apart from that, you know, the leaping in, and he's trying to close the distance. I think it's Jayson that is now starting to counter him. He's starting to pick him apart on the feet.
Just the way you said before. If he keep on staying on orthodox, Jayson is using his distance, and he's still keeping on countering and punching.
Exactly.
But when he stay on orthodox, when he stay on southpaw, Nutlai is doing good job because he kept on catching him with some straight over right hand and body shot.
Exactly. And we just saw that in the replay again. He switched for a second. That left hand landed constantly. But otherwise, the minute he was in orthodox, Jayson was in.
Then I don't know why. That's the work of his team. That they're supposed to be advising him now to stay. If you stay on a specific position and it's working, then you have to stick on that plan.
Maybe we should scream louder.
Then we should be biased.
Round number six. Oh, round number seven. Sorry.
Round
yes,
number seven.
Round number seven now.
Three more rounds to go.
Three more rounds to go. 8, 9, and 10. And then we are done and done. It's going to be a tough one to score. Here we go. Round number seven in this incredible championship fight. If you're just joining us, this fight is for the WBC Asia Continental Light Flyweight title.
Brought to you by DJMC.
Thank you, brother. Brought to you by DJMC Boxing. Exclusively in the beautiful WTC Arena.
I kind of like the way DJMC, when they stepped in the Middle East promoting boxing, they changed the whole scenario and in boxing events in Dubai.
Yep.
And I had them right now. They want to explode, and maybe in future we don't know. Maybe they might be going to Africa, or maybe
that's
also
incredible. Yeah.
That would be incredible.
I would love to come to Africa with you, man.
Maybe I should give them this hint, because they can get good talent from Africa, where I come from.
Oh, we can do a specific card for them.
Yeah.
But that is a matter for another day, because right now we are deep in the lower end of a massive title fight, where neither man is looking to quit. If anything, it strengthened their resolve to try and see this outcome to an end.
Good body shot from Jayson.
Jayson, I'm telling you, it's Jayson has just woken up, and we both agree.
Uppercut. Oh my
beautiful
god!
Beautiful lead uppercut by Jayson. Is Lalbiakkima needs to just. I'm so sorry. Nutlai has to just switch stances. He needs to. Well, you know, I don't know if he's going to switch stances. But
yeah, he needs to switch stance, because we saw from the first round and the second round he was doing very good.
First, second, and third, even.
Yes,
I would have given.
He was doing very good when he was on southpaw. But again, whenever he switched to southpaw to other dogs.
Look at this! Look at, he might be switching to southpaw. He switched. Oh, he switched back. The referee admonishing his opponent for something. Now, wait, hang on a second. Now he switched to southpaw. He switched to southpaw. And immediately, you can see Jayson getting a little uncomfortable.
Yeah, whenever he changed to southpaw.
Exactly. The minute he switches to southpaw,
see,
he gets uncomfortable.
He's scoring some good punches whenever he switched to the southpaw.
Exactly, because the angle of approach changes.
Good movement from Jayson.
And now he's
Jayson.
Back to orthodox. Oh, again. Again, in orthodox, he gets countered.
Look,
immediately.
He doesn't respond each and every time he stays on orthodox.
Exactly. It's frustrating to see, because it's, you know, I'm pretty sure he's getting the best advice from his corner, but I think he must realize himself.
Maybe he gets excited each and every time.
You know, it's only when he gets excited is when he's actually switching stances.
Oh, good
nice
body shot from
body
both
shot.
Of them.
Both these guys. Now switch. If he's looking to switch, this would be a good time. He's still in orthodox. He's looking for that massive monster right hand.
Power punch. And I don't think that can buy right
now. No, it's not.
Because Jayson realized.
No, because Jason's rolling away from it. He's not rolling away from that left.
Good job from both of them.
Great exchanges. Great punches from both these men. Man, this is a fight. And now both of them have calmed down. They both. See, again, he's
good
leaping
counter.
In. And that's where Jayson is making him pay.
That's a slip.
That's a slip.
That's a slip.
And that's the end of the round. We go into round number 8. The last three rounds remaining.
Oh, my God.
That I think somebody needs to go. I think, Nick, just go over. Just tell him. Switch to southpaw.
To stay on southpaw, right? My friend, you need to stay to southpaw. I don't know if you can hear me. You need to stay on southpaw.
You know, what we're doing is not right. But yeah, of course.
I'm just doing
yelling.
My job. I'm just doing my job. I can see. I can overview both sides. And Jayson need to stay on the way he was doing the first round,
yeah,
doing some counter punches, and it was working for him.
Let's take a look at those replays. It's just over and over again. We saw Jayson countering, but we saw the proof. The minute, for a few seconds, for about I think 20 seconds or 30 seconds, when he switched to southpaw,
it's working for him.
It worked for him because it's that angle. Jayson doesn't like that left
and
hand
it
coming.
It doesn't work for Jayson.
It doesn't work for Jayson.
And I don't know the reason why. Whenever he works, he gets excited and he forget what he did. And
exactly.
He again he switches to orthodox.
And the minute he comes back to orthodox,
he
Jayson catches
punished.
Him. Boom! Okay, Jason's punishing him. Nice body shot there. Again, in orthodox, Jason's ready. Jayson sees it coming. Beautiful left hook, uppercut.
Good
catch.
Uppercut from
beautiful
Jayson.
Uppercut catching him when he comes in.
Good hook from Jayson again.
That's what we're
good
saying.
Good uppercut from Jayson again.
It's just that's the thing. Nutlai becomes a moving. It's just a walking target in orthodox. And in southpaw, he hides that left hand, and you don't see it coming.
And each and every time he catch him, but I don't know why the team is not working, asking him to stay on the same position.
Jayson doing a very good job trying to counter and gets out of harm's way. Nutlai trying to find an opening with that jab. Again, that fast ball of a right hand just getting out of the way. But that's what we said. Jayson is seeing it coming. He's seeing it coming a mile away because Nutlai is only looking to set up that right hand. Yes, he's landing some good hooks. He landed a good left hook there. Landed a good body shot. Jayson.
Good job from Jayson. Nice uppercut.
Man, Jason's uppercuts when he's catching it.
Oh,
beautiful combination. Speed. Oh, but look
again,
at this.
I think that corner is not good. It's a bit wet.
Yeah, I think that corner has dropped a little bit of water there.
Yeah.
And that can injure a fighter because of a slip.
Yeah, they need to get one, not to keep on pouring water on the corner.
Yeah, I mean that's part. You know, they're giving the it's just to cool the fighter down, and it's the corner's job to keep it clean, make sure there's no water. Nice shots in the clinch, and you see again, Jayson is smart. He's slowed down because he knows he needs to go hard again for the next two rounds.
Oh,
oh my God! How is Nutlai standing? He's eaten so many counters, stepping in. Big overhand right and a good left. Very, very nice. Wow, he swings for the fences.
If that punch catch him, he go to bed.
Yeah, I don't dispute that one bit. He's again. That's a big slip.
Something
needs to be done about this.
Something needs to be done there.
Oh man, Nutlai just stepping. I think there's something hurt Jayson.
That's what I'm talking about. He need to stop jumping on those punches. Because if Jayson just get to...
Oh, he caught him with that right hand. No, but it's there's something up. Jayson has gotten a little... It's I don't know whether he's slowed down or he's gotten hit by a hard shot. And Nutlai just coming, stepping in, looking to land that. A barrage of shots ending with that huge overhand right. Oh, big left hook. Oh, big overhand right, and that one connected. And you can see Jayson felt that one immediately. But man, what a chin.
Jayson has a great chin, man.
No, his eyes just opened wide. It's because of that shot that connected. He's got a great chin, absolutely. Both these men have a great chin. And we go into round number eight. Is it eight or nine?
Nine.
We go to round number nine now. Wow. You know, the last time I was here, there was a fighter named Sachin Dekwal, and he was fighting against a Pakistani opponent. And he went in DJMC Series 3, and he went to the 10th round, and he knocked him out in the 10th round.
And they were fighting for the WBC.
Yes. For
Asian,
the
Middle East Asian
title. Yes. And they fought, and Sachin Dekwal knocked him out in the 10th round.
Wow.
That is incredible. They fought hard for nine rounds, and then, like both these men are doing, they're giving it their all. It's given them 200%. But in that 10th round, bang, knockout.
And the fight was done.
It was absolutely incredible. Here we go, ninth, and one more round after this to decide it. As you can see, both these men are getting a little more aggressive and going after it. We saw a lot of action, a lot of heavy action in the first three rounds, four rounds, and then it slowed down a little bit in the fifth, sixth, with Jayson taking control all over again. But in the last fight, in the last round, Nutlai came in like a crazy man, trying to find to end that fight with the combinations. I think that round would go to Nutlai in the last one.
Yeah, that's round we give to Nutlai.
Yeah, but it's a tough fight to score, because I don't know how they're scoring. Again, that big overhand right.
Nikokwa fight.
Jayson trying to come in, catch him with some combinations. But Nutlai will not be denied. He's stepping in with everything he's got. He's trying to land that left hook overhand.
You know what? I was telling you before, yeah?
If Nutlai keep... Sorry to cut you off, Nick. Oh, Jesus, they're getting stuck in with these shots. Again, that beautiful, big left hand. Shh, man. It's just, it's, you know, ladies and gentlemen, you have to see this from where we're sitting. We can hear every thud.
Oh,
every smack.
What a body shot.
And you can see Jason tried to clinch with that hand immediately to stop the action because that body shot would have done some damage. And now the referee admonishing him, saying, do not lock the arm.
I don't know what Nutlai ate from the corner.
Oh, he's woken up with a different spin. And look at that head movement. He got out of a 10-punch combination. 1-2 by Jason, and he's egging him on. It's just his aggression. I think he just knows now. Just, you know, it's got 6 minutes remaining in this fight. I'm going to step in.
And his belt is on the way.
And his belt is on the line. And it's you know, it's a big opportunity, and he wants to be champion. Both these men want to be champion.
They want to be champion.
If it was up to me, both men should deserve a belt, honestly. But that's not how it
works.
Oh my God.
Good combination from Nutlai.
Oh, a double body shot. Both these men, incredible action in front of us. They are going for broke, ladies and gentlemen. Neither man is giving each other a moment to breathe. Body shot after body shot after body shot. What are they made of?
What a good night.
Wow.
Good job from Nutlai.
Man, what a
And he
flurry.
Doesn't look like he's done anything, man.
No, he's not even breathing heavy. He's smiling. He's having a good time. And this is what he wants. He wants to shove him into a corner. But man, don't tell me that last flurry was just incredible. Didn't take a lot of energy out of these men.
Nothing.
Beautiful combination.
Nothing.
By Jason. Nothing.
Oh my God. Oh.
Look at them go. Oh. Both of them. Body
Both
shot.
Of them exchanging some punches.
Body shot after body shot after body shot.
I didn't even hear the bell.
Oh man, nobody heard the bell. I don't know what's happening anymore because both these men have decided that this fight is not going to the judges' scorecard.
If you haven't been in Ukraine, if you've never gone to a war.
This is a war that we are seeing in front of us, ladies and gentlemen. It is pure fire and fury.
Real men at work. Real men at work.
Real men at work.
I've never seen such kind of energy.
I've never seen this kind of, at one point they were just body shot after body shot.
Fire after fire.
Body shot. I just don't, and it's just, it looked like it was hit so many times, so many counters. It's true, but after a point you get numb. And I think he's so numb that he doesn't feel it coming.
He doesn't feel the pain now.
He doesn't feel the pain. He'll feel it tomorrow. But right now, he's in the zone. He's got 3 minutes of fire remaining.
We go to the last round of the 10.
You think he's going to go to the judges? Yeah, it is.
Of course it's going to be the judges. These guys, they don't look like they're going to give up.
They're not going to they're not going to knock each other out. But
no
if it
way.
Happens,
they
I've
can.
Seen it happen in the 10th round. It can happen. Anything can happen in the sport.
This is a fight that is going to give the judges a hard time.
This is going to be a tough fight to score because it's close. It's really close. And Jason, again, taking the lead here. He's using that reach and length of his. But Nutlai stepping into the pocket. That's a slip. That's not a knockdown. Yes, that's a great job by the referee.
That's good job.
It's a very good job by the referee. He noticed, he knew it was a slip and not a knockdown.
That's right.
But this is getting very, very interesting now.
That's good job from the referee. Oh my God.
Again, beautiful 1-2 left, right. And now Nutlai comes back to the fire. Jason doing everything in his power to keep him off him.
Oh my God. This is the real fire. This is the real
Good
fight.
God.
If you've never seen a fight.
I've never seen someone throw down like that. This is.
And the guy, they don't look even tired.
Oh big God. Overhead right. He hurt him. Oh wow. He's got him backing up. Oh man. Nutlai caught him with that huge right hand. But the recovery of Jayson Vayson. But Nutlai smells blood. He knows he's got him on the ropes.
Jayson doing a good job. Nutlai doing a good job.
Oh my God. How do you score a winner?
Oh my God. Oh, real fire here.
Incredible. That's a knockdown.
That's a knockdown.
No, he's calling it a slip. According to me, it was a knockdown. It was a knockdown. Because he ate four punches and he went down on one knee. But what is Nutlai's chin made of? It's just something as huge.
These guys, they need both of them. They really need to take the belt at home.
It's my God. They need both these guys should get the belt because I've never seen this kind of fire.
Oh,
big combination from Jason. You know what? I need to review that. I think that was a knockdown.
That was a knockdown for me.
Yes.
That was a knockdown for me.
I think he got lucky that the referee thought it was a slip. But you can see the pace slowing down. Both these men have given it their all.
They have given all the best. They are real. These are warriors.
This is, oh my God, I have no more words. I'm losing my voice. And both these men, the respect and admiration, the effort that they've put in, the amount of punches, the punishment that they've taken, all for the quest for winning that belt. The WBC Asia Continental Light Flyweight title belt. And man, oh man, there is no quit in either warrior.
Oh my God, this was a real fight.
It is an incredible fight about to come to a close, and neither man is backing down.
Nobody is backing down. No one is slowing down. The same speed from the first round we started.
Exactly.
It's the same speed they have.
If anything, I think it's become crazier now. Oh my God. What are these men made of? I can't repeat myself enough.
Oh my God.
Big uppercut there by Jayson. And that is the end of the fight. What a fight, ladies and gentlemen. What a fight. Incredible action for 10 rounds. Amazing. Amazing. I have no words. It's just spectacular. And look at these men.
One of
these
the best
men
fights.
Are spent. You can see the fatigue on their faces. But not for once did they let go of that opportunity to become the WBC Asia Continental Flyweight title holders.
Now
wow.
we go to the
Well, now we go to the judges' scorecard. It's going to be a tough one because you see from the replay, both these men gave it their all. Yes, it got a little sloppy in the last two rounds, but it got more and more frenetic. It got more and more crazy. And we can see both fighters gave it. It's a battle for a belt. It's a battle for glory. And that's what we get in the main event of a DJMC boxing promotion. Man. I mean, you know what? Win, lose, or draw. Both these men are winners.
They are warriors. I don't care.
Give them both the belt.
Yes.
Make it a draw and then let them fight again.
Yes. They did a very good, incredible job.
And you know, whoever the winner is, I don't care. I think both these men can rematch down the line.
That's right.
They can absolutely rematch down the line because they're so evenly matched.
That's right.
Two different styles clashing. One technical, one more of a brawler. Incredible, incredible scenes, incredible performance. People are on their feet. Wow.
And they don't look tired.
And that's just a secret, I think. I don't know what's in the water. But yeah, and he's not even tired. He's not even breathing. Look, by now I would have been, one of my lungs would have been out of the body. I would be coughing that hard. This guy's not even breathing heavy. I mean, it's incredible.
They did a great job. Both fighters were
incredible job
on peak from the first round to the last round.
Wow.
For me, if I was a judge,
this is why I'm not a judge.
Yes. It would be so hard.
Oh man, it's going to be something. You know, the judges have a tough one. This is going to take some time to figure out, but I think that we might have reached a decision because Jared Kyle has that paper in his hand.
Let's see how it takes from there.
Man, my heart is beating, man. We're going a little crazy. I don't know who's going to win.
This is not even the fight that I can come and say whoever won or whoever didn't win. Both fighters did a
Both fighters
very
won,
good job.
According to me.
Very good. They did a very good job.
I got to watch the tape again. I mean, even though we just called the fight.
Yeah, we need
but
to
I
watch
need to
the
go
fight.
Back and watch the tape. Incredible scenes.
Ladies and gentlemen. After 10 spectacular rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. The judges code the bout 94-97, 97-93, and 94-96 for your winner. And now, the WBC Asia Continental Champion, Jayson Vayson!
I knew, you know. But I'll be damned if that was not a close fight. That was so incredibly
both
close.
Boxers, regardless of what happened, both boxers did a very good job.
And you can see the Filipino fans screaming in the background. They're all celebrating their fighter. And Jayson Vayson is beside himself. The emotionality, the tears. Emotionality, the tears is coming out.
We had some angry fans in the background, not happy with the outcome, but that's part of the sport.
Yeah, it is what it is. At the end of the day, we have a winner and we have a loser.
Yeah, it happens. That's part of the sport. It's absolutely fine. That happens. It's part of it. You can see the man. He's upset that his fighter didn't win. It's okay.
But he did a good job.
He has nothing to be bad about. He has nothing to be upset about. It is an incredible scene. It is incredible performance put together by this man. And Jayson Vayson, both men are deserving of the belt.
That's right.
Jayson took it. He did a little more on the scorecard. We need to go back and watch that fight. And I think that it was that middle part, you know, that fourth round.
I think there was a knockdown.
It was a knockdown. The judges saw the
knockdown, which the referee didn't see.
Yes.
That's where maybe
he saw the knockdown as well. Yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
And I think it's that knockdown which made all the difference.
That's right. Yes. Because Natalie was doing very good job.
It was. They both were even, but I think Jayson, towards the end of that fight, in the middle section, landed the heavier shots. He landed the cleanup punches. And even though, you know, it's Nutlai.
For the influencer fights,
just
those
amazing.
Are spectacular. But even
he did a
bigger
good job.
Round of applause
he did a very
for
good
DJMC
job.
Events
I can see all the Filipino family
a
doing
a spectacular night of fights, a spectacular night of action, a spectacular night of drama, and a spectacular 10 round main event. Give it up for Dunstan Rosario. Give it up for Roshan Nathaniel and for both our fighters, Jayson Vayson and Nutlai Lalbiakkima. What a night of spectacular fights. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. And we will see you again, like Dunstan said, in October.